أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تدخلوا بيوت النبي إلا أن يؤذن لكم إلى طعام غير ناظرين إناه، ولكن إذا دعيتم فادخلوا فإذا طعمتم فانتشروا لا مستأنسين لحديث. صدق الله العظيم. Oh, you who believe, don't enter the houses of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam illa an yuzana lakum, except when it is permitted to you or except when you are called for that. Ila ta'amin, for some feast. Ghaira nazirina ina, not waiting for the preparation of the meals. Walakin idha du'itum fadkhulu, but when you are called, you should enter. فَإِذَا تَعِنْتُمْ فَانْتَشِرُوا, and when you have taken the meals, now you go away, you leave. وَلَا مُسْتَانِسِينَ لِحَدِيثِ, and don't linger there for some talks. إِنَّ ذَلِكُمْ كَانَ يُوزِ النَّبِيَّ, this attitude of yours was annoying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَيَسْتَحِي مِنْكُمْ, but he was shy of you, he couldn't say. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَسْتَحِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ, and Allah is not shy from saying whatever is truth. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُنَّ مَتَاعًا, and if you have to ask for something, some goods from the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاسْأَلُوهُنَّ مِنْ وَرَائِ حِجَابٍ, so ask them from behind a curtain. This is very important ayah, and on this is based the concept of hijab, مِنْ وَرَائِ حِجَاب. So curtain should be there. A curtain, if it is on the door of the house, it is curtain. A curtain before the face of a Muslim woman is the veil. It's also a curtain. ذَلِكُمْ أَطْهَرُ لِقُلُوبِكُمْ وَقُلُوبِهِنَّ, this is purer for your hearts and their hearts. وَمَا كَانَ لَكُمْ أَن تُؤْذُوا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَلَا أَن تَنكِحُوا أَزْوَاجَهُ مِن بَعْدِهِ أَبَدًا, and this is not at all permissible for you, and it doesn't behove of you that you should annoy the Messenger of Allah, nor that you should marry his wives after him. Abadan, ever. Inna zalikum kana inda Allahi azima, this is with Allah, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a very great sin. In tumdu shayyan aw tufuhu, if you conceal something or you reveal it, fa inna Allah kana bi kulli shayin alima, it is equal for Allah. Allah knows everything. لا جناح عليهن في آبائهن. Now when the other believers were stopped from entering the houses of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except when called. Now there is being given a list of the persons, of the relations who are exempted from this stopping of entering into the houses of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لا جناح عليهن في آبائهن. There is no blame on them if their fathers, wala abnaihinna, or their sons, wala ikhwanihinna, or their brothers, wala abnai ikhwanihinna, or the sons of their brothers, wala abnai akhawatihinna, or the sons of their daughters, wala nisaihinna, and not their own women, not strange women, their own women, wala ma malakat aymanuhunna, and also not for those whom their right hands possess. But a group says that this includes the male slaves also, but some say that only the female, the slave girls. وَاتَّقِينَ اللَّهِ, so these are the people who are allowed to enter the houses of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the beginning of the list of mahram. This list is completed in Suratul Nur. Surah An-Nur was revealed after this, 1 year later than Surah Ahzab. So the beginning is here, but the completion of this commandment of Allah is in Surah An-Nur. Inna Allah kana ala kulli shay'in shahida. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witness over everything. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Surely Allah and His angels send blessings on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi. O you who believe, you also send your blessings on him. Wa sallimu taslima, and salute him with a becoming salutation. Inna alladhina yuzuna Allah wa rasulahu. Surely who give pain or annoy Allah and His Messenger. La'anahum Allahu fi dunya wal akhirah. Allah has cursed them in the life of this world as well as in akhirah, in the hereafter. Wa'adda lahum azaban muhina. And Allah has prepared for them a very humiliating chastisement. Waladina yuzun al mu'minina wal mu'minat bighayr maktasabu faqad ihtamalu buhtan wa isman azima. Mubina. And those who give pain to mu'min believers, male believers and women believers, without their having earned that, they have not committed any sin, they have not committed any wrong thing, but people, you know, are saying slanders against them, then such people, فَقَدْ اِحْتَمَلُوا بُهْتَانًا. So they have taken upon them a slander, وَإِسْمَ مُبِينَا, a very big sin. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِي, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ لِأَزْوَاجِكَ, say to your wives, وَبَنَاتِكَ, and your daughters, وَنِسَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Now you know this, the commandments are being extended gradually from beyond the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to other women also of the Muslims. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ قُلْ لِأَزْوَاجِكَ وَبَنَاتِكَ وَنِسَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, say to your wives, to your daughters, and to the women, and to the wives of the believers, يُدْنِينَ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ, they should draw their cloaks over their faces. ذَلِكَ أَدْنَى يُعْرَفْنَ فَلَا يُزَيْنَ, that is, that will be nearer, that they should be recognized, that they belong to respectable families, they are not the slave girls, so that they will not be teased. فَلَا يُزَيْنَ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا, and Allah is forgiving and merciful. Now actually in Arabia, before Islam came, there was no segregation of sexes. But the covering of body was okay there. They used to cover their bodies, males and females both. But they never, the women never covered their faces. But it was customary that they had every man and every woman, when he or she went out from the house, they took a long cloth and put them, you know, about them. So, but the women shouldn't, they used it. They are called jalbab. One is khumr. Khumr have been mentioned in Surah An-Nur. Wadribna, walyadribna bikhumurihinna ala jalabi bihinna. These are the scars. We have dupattas in India, in Pakistan, etc. These are khumr. Because they are used in the house. So that is mentioned in Surah An-Nur. Because the rules and etiquettes within the house, they are discussed in Surah An-Nur. But when going out, a bigger, you know, wrapping cloth. But the only thing that was said, that was added to it was, that a part of that, you know, over cloth, you may call it, that should come in front of the face. يُدْنِينَ عَلَيْهِنَّ مِنْ جَلَابِيبِهِنَّ. لَإِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهِ الْمُنَافِقُونَ, if the hypocrites, وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ, and those in whose hearts are a disease, they don't resist. وَالْمُرْجِفُونَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ, and those who want to produce commotion in Medina, لَنُغْرِيَنَّكَ بِهِمْ, that we shall urge you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, against them. فَلَا يُجَاوِرُونَكَ فِيهَا إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, and then they will not be able to live in this city of Medina after you, with you, but very little. Up till now, there was no action was taken against Munafiqeen. The action against Munafiqeen was taken only after the Ghazwa of Tabuk. That was the time when, first of all, the door of repentance was closed to Munafiqun. The Prophet was commanded not to pray for them if they die. Some of the munafiqeen, the Prophet identified by names and said, go out of our mosque. Then the Prophet burnt their mosque, Masjid Ziraran. And in the same way, because there was no action being taken against them, here it is a threat. If you don't desist from your activities, these type of activities, then maybe we command our Prophet to take an action against you. Maluneen, they are the accursed ones. Aina ma suqifu, wherever they may be found. Ukhizu, they should be taken, seized. Wa quttilu taqtila, and slain, relentlessly, into pieces. Sunnat Allah fil ladhina khalaw min qabl. And that has been Allah's practice with those who passed away before. وَلَن تَجَدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا, and you won't find for the sunnah and law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala any change. يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ, people are asking you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the hour, when that as-sa'ah, that qiyamah would come. قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, say, the knowledge of that hour is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّ السَّاعَةَ تَكُونُ قَرِيبًا, and what shall make you realize that maybe that hour has come very near? Inna Allaha la'ana al-kafirina wa a'adda lahum sa'ira. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed the disbelievers and prepared for them a flaming fire. Khalidina fi abada. They will remain therein forever. La yajiduna waliyyan wala nasira. They will not find for them any protector nor any helper. Yawma tuqallabu wujuhum fi an-nar. When their faces will be turned from this side to that, from that to this, in the fire, يَقُولُونَ, and they will say, يَا لَيْتَنَا أَطَعْنَا اللَّهَ وَأَطَعْنَا الرَّسُولَ, oh, would that we had obeyed Allah, and would that we had obeyed the Messenger of Allah. وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّا أَطَعْنَا سَادَتَنَا وَكُبَرَانَا فَادَلُّونَ السَّبِيلَ, and they will say, oh, our Lord, we only obeyed our leaders and our elders, and they led us astray from the right path. Rabbana atihim zayfaini min al-azab. O our Lord, give them double chastisement. Wal'anhum la'anan kabira, and curse them with a great curse. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la takunu kal ladhina azaw Musa. O you who believe, be not like those who had annoyed or who had said bad things about Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. فَبَرَّهُ اللَّهُ مِمَّا قَالُوا, but then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleared him off what they said. Now there are stories about this in the ahadith, that because Musa alayhi salam was very shy, so people thought that he has some defect in his body, in his organs. And that is why he's so shy and he keeps, you know, always covered. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in some way he disclosed to the people, and they could see Musa alayhi salam that he was absolutely healthy and absolutely full. فَبَرَّهُ اللَّهُ مِمَّا قَالُ وَكَانَ إِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَجِيهَا, and he was in the sight of Allah a very honored person. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا. O you who believe, have fear of Allah, and say only that thing which is straight and true. Control your tongues. Have the taqwa of Allah in your hearts and control your tongues. If you do these two things, accomplish these two things, yuslih lakum a'malakum. Allah promises that He will rectify all of your deeds. Wa yaghfir lakum dhunubakum. And if there are some, you know, mistakes, some sins, some wrong commitments, then He will forgive you. Wa man yuti'i Allah wa rasulahu faqad faza fawzan 'azima. And whosoever takes it binding on him to obey Allah and His Messenger, then he indeed has a mighty triumph. He is successful. He has attained a very big success. Inna aradna al-amanata ala samawati wal-ard wal-jibal fa-bayna yahmilnaha. Surely we offered our trust to the heavens and the earth and the mountains, but they refused to undertake it. Washfaqna minha, and they were afraid of it. وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانِ, but man undertook it. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا, verily he was unjust and foolish. This is one of the most difficult ayat of of Quran, and there are many differences in its interpretation. What I understand, may Allah set me right if I am wrong, but I understand that this is the amana of the ruh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which was blown in Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. This ruh, jinnat don't have. This ruh, the animals on this earth don't have. The angels are simply ruh. They are arwah only. They have no bodies. So they have one-sided type of existence. The only creature which has both sides of creation is man. And it was man only who could have that trust of Allah, the ruh of Allah, and hold it. And that is why man was created to be a vicegerent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِسْقَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةَ إِنِّي جَعَيْلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. The vicegerent. So actually man, before the ruh was blown into him, he was unjust, foolish. He was just an animal. Before this blowing of the spirit of Allah, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. Twice these words have appeared in Quran, in Surah Al-Hijr, in Surah Al-Saad. So when I have fashioned him fully, and you know, given all the finishing touches to him, and then when I blow into him from my own ruh, وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ, then you shall fall down before him in prostration. فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ. These words also appear twice in Quran. All the angels prostrated before him. So actually this was this ruh which could be taken by self, by man only and none else. Before that he was an animal. He was not a human being. And as an animal, when Allah says, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, there are two extreme things about man in Quran. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ التَّقْوِيمِ. We have created, you know, man in the best fashion, best way. But on the other hand, خُلَقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلِ, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, كَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا, خُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ عَجَلِ. All these things are there. So why? How do you reconcile? The human being before getting the spirit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was weak, was ajula, was halua. Inna lisana kala halua, halua, ajula, and he was made out of ajul. All these things were there. But when this ruh was inspired or instilled into him, then he became highest of the highest, higher than the highest. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمِ. أَحْسَن, superlative degree. Then we sent him down to the lowest. Without ruh, he is the lowest. With ruh, he is the highest. So this is what I think. So that is why I have translated, إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Surely he was unjust and foolish. Not after receiving the spirit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these words are not applicable to him. لَيُعَظِّبَ اللَّهُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ. The end would have been in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What would be the end of all this? Why he created this? Why this creation of life and death? خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. The end would be, لِيُعَظِّبَ اللَّهُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ. So that Allah should chastise those women who were hypocrite, and men who were hypocrite, and those men who were associated with Allah, false gods, والمشركات, and those women who were associated with Allah, false gods, ويتوب الله على المؤمنين, and that Allah should lean and relent towards the believing men and women. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا, and verily Allah is forgiving, merciful. Now we come to a pair of the surahs, which both start with the words Alhamdulillah. Surah Saba and Surah Fatir. A pair, beautiful pair. And I pointed out earlier also, this is something interesting. With Alhamdulillah, Suratul Fatiha. beginning of the first part. Again with Alhamdulillah, Suratul An'am, in the eighth part, after seven parts. Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَجَعَلَ ظُلُمَاتِ وَالنُّورِ. Then again, a gap of seven parts of Quran, and we find another Alhamdulillah in Surah Kahf. Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ الْكِتَابَ وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ عِوَجًا. Then again, a gap of exactly seven parts of Quran. Again, we have Surah Al-Saba, and here there are two. Surah Al-Saba and Surah Al-Fatir. Alhamdulillah. Now, these are facts and figures. What is the connotation? I can't say. But maybe, if these statistics are kept in front, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometime, you know, gives you some light that this is the reason why, you know, this Alhamdulillah, these kalimat have been repeated in Quran with this sequence. Wallahu alam. Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. All praise be to Allah. All belongs to Allah. To whom belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. And for him exclusively will be the praise in the hereafter. In this world, others are also praised. Kings are praised, and presidents are praised, and you know, addresses of welcome are given, and so forth and so on. But in Akhirah, the only one will be praised, and he will be Allah. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. Exclusive. وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. And he is the wise, the aware. يَعْلَمُ مَا يَلِجُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. He knows whatever enters into the earth. وَمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنْهَا. And what comes out from it. وَمَا يَنْزُلُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. And whatsoever is coming down from the skies, from the heaven. وَمَا يَعْرُجُ فِيهَا. And whatever is ascending into it. وَهُوَ الرَّحِيمُ الْغَفُورُ. And he is the merciful, the forgiver. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَعْتِينَ السَّاعَةِ. These believers are claiming that no hour is going to come over us. No hour, no qiyamah, no resurrection, no akhirah, nothing of this sort. قُلْ بَلَا وَرَبِّي لَتَعْتِيَنَّكُمْ. Say, why not? I swear by my Lord that hour will definitely come over you. عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ. I swear by my Lord who is the knower of all the unseen. لَا يَعْزُبُ عَنْهُ مِثْقَالُ ذَرَّةٍ. Not even anything equal to the atom's weight escapes his notice. Neither in the heavens, فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ, nor in the earth. وَلَا أَصْغَرُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And there is nothing smaller than that, وَلَا أَكْبَرُ. And nothing greater than that, إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Except that everything is written in the book, clear book. لَيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. So that Allah should reward those who come to believe and do good deeds. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. They will be the ones for whom there will be forgiveness and there will be generous provision. وَالَّذِينَ سَعَوْا فِي آيَاتِنَا مُعَاجِزِينَ. As for those who are striving against our revelations to defeat them, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ وَرِزْقٌ أَلِيمٌ. For them there is the chastisement, painful scourge and torment. وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ. And those who were given knowledge, they see that whatever has been revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is truth. Just like the people from Abyssinia, just like Najashi, just like Abdul Salam, Abdullah ibn Salam, radiyallahu ta'ala. وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ. وَيَهْدِي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الرَّحِيمِ. And this what has been revealed to you, O Muhammad, is guiding the people to the path of the Al-Aziz, the mighty, Al-Hamid, the praiseworthy. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And these disbelievers say, هَلْ نَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ رَجُلٍ. Should we show you or point to you a person, a man who says, يُنَبِّئُكُمْ, who tells you, إِذَا مُزِّقْتُمْ كُلَّ مُمَزَّقٍ. When you will be disintegrated totally in the clay, after your death, your bodies will decay, become clay and meet with clay. And all your parts will be separated and scattered. إِذَا مُزِّقْتُمْ كُلَّ مُمَزَّقٍ. إِنَّكُمْ لَفِي خَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. He says then, you will be in a new creation. You will be resurrected. You will be again given the life. افترى على الله كذبا. Has he forged a lie against Allah? That is intentionally, knowingly. Does he want to deceive us intentionally, knowingly? Hum bihi jinnah. Or there is some madness with him? Has he lost his balance? Or is there some evil spirit which has possessed him? بَلِ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ فِي الْعَذَابِ وَالضَّلَالِ مُبِينٍ. Nay, but the truth is that those who don't believe in the hereafter, they are already in chastisement and they are in a very far error. أَفَلَمْ يَرَوْا إِلَى مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. So don't they see what is in front of them and what is behind them from the earth? In nasha naqsif bihim. What does it mean? The history. The history which is behind them. What happened to Qawm Aad, the people of Aad and the people of Samud, etc., etc. This is behind them. The history. Don't they recall it? And don't see whatever is in front of them. All this universe full of signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In nasha naqsif bihim al-arda aw nuskat alayhim kithaban min as-samaa'. If we want and wish, we can make the earth swallow them. Or cause a fragment of the heaven to fall down upon them. Inna fi zalika la ayatan li kulli 'abdin munib. Verily, in this is a sign for all those persons, for all those bondsmen of ours, servants, who care for us. Wa laqad atayna Dawooda minna fadla. And we gave our bounties to Dawood alayhi salatu wassalam. Ya jibalu wa bi ma'ahu. We had commanded the mountains, repeat our praises with him. وَالطَّيْرَ. And the birds, you also do it. وَعَلَلْنَا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. And we had softened the iron for him. أَنِعْمَلْ سَابِغَاتٍ وَقَدِّرْ فِي السَّرْدِ. O Dawood, make for people wide coats of mail. And mayor well the links. وَعَمَلُوا صَالِحًا. And do righteous deeds. إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Surely, what you are doing, I am seeing. وَلَيْ سُلَيْمَانَ رِيحَ. And we subjected for Sulaiman the wind. غُدُوُّهَا شَهْرٌ. Its morning course was a month's journey. وَرَوَاهُهَا شَهْرٌ. In the same way, the evening course was equal to 1 month's journey. وَأَسَلْنَا لَهُ عَيْنَ الْقِطْرِ. And we made flow for him a fountain of molten brass. وَمِنَ الْجِنِّ. And we subjected for him the jinns. مَنْ يَعْمَلُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. Who used to work in front of him. بَيْزْنِ رَبِّهِ. By the Lord, by the command of his Lord. وَمَنْ يَزِغْ مِنْهُمْ عَنْ أَمْرِنَا. And whosoever would swerve from among them, from our commandment, نُزِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ. Then we shall make him taste the chastisement of the blazing fire. يَعْمَلُونَ لَهَا. These jinnat, they were making for him mahariba, very lofty and very beautiful buildings, structures. وَتَمَاسِيلَ. And images. وَجِفَانٍ كَالْجَوَابِ. And basins like troughs. وَقُدُورِ الرَّاسِيَاتِ. And anchored cooking pots. اَعْمَلُوا عَلَى دَاوُدَ شُكْرًا. O family of Dawood, work you with thanks. وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. And verily, very few amongst my people, my servants, are really grateful. فَلَمَّا قَضَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَوْتِ. When we decreed death on Sulaiman alayhi salam, مَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مَوْتِهِ. Nobody could inform them of his death. إِلَّا دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ. Except a creature from the earth. تَعْكُلُ مِنْ سَعَتَهُ. Which devoured his staff. He was standing, taking support from his staff, and he died. But he kept standing. His dead body kept standing in the same way. And the jinnats thought that he is alive. And he is seeing us, supervising us. But then, you know, that termite, that demak, دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ, that ate that staff. And then when it broke, he fell. His dead body fell down. فَلَمَّا خَرَّ. When he fell down, تَبَيَّنَتِ الْجِنِّ. The jinns came to know. And لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ الْغَيْبِ Had they known the unseen, مَا لَبِسُوا فِي الْعَذَابِ الْمُهِينِ They would not have been here in this humiliating chastisement. They never came to know that Sulaiman is already dead. لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَعٍ فِي مَسَاكِنِهِمْ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ Now this mention of the people of Saba has come before also. It is being mentioned again here. The queen of Saba, Sheba, and how, you know, the ultimatum letter was sent by Sulaiman alayhi salatu wassalam to her, and she came and surrendered herself. Now this is the nation of Sheba, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them also some messengers. And Allah has given them much of His blessings and bounties, but they proved to be disgrateful. They were not grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they were punished. This story is coming here. لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَعٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٍ For the people of Saba, in their dwelling place, there was an ayah, there was a sign. جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينٍ وَأَشْبَالٍ Two gardens, continuous gardens, a highway in between, and a garden is a long series of gardens. On the right side, long series of gardens on the left side of the highway. جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينٍ وَشِمَالٍ كُلُوا مِنْ رِزْكَ رَبَّكُمْ As if we had said to them, now you eat of this food and provision that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord has given you. وَشْكُرُوا لَهُ But be thankful to Him. بَلْدَةٌ تَيِّبَةٌ These dwelling places, this country of yours is very good. وَرَبٌّ غَفُورٌ And the Lord is forgiving. فَآرَضُوا But then they turned away. فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَيْلَ الْعَرِمِ So we sent upon them the inundation and flood of the dam. وَبَدَّلْنَاهُمْ All these gardens were destroyed. As if, you know, a big dam, if it is, it gives way, what will happen? What havoc would it bring? MaazAllah. If something happens to Mangala Dam or to Tarbela Dam, what would happen to Pakistan? It's very bad. This thing happened there. Sail al-Arimi. وَبَدَّلْنَاهُمْ بِجَنَّتَيْهِمْ And now we changed in place of their gardens. جَنَّتَيْنِ Now there were gardens, but they had what? زَوَاتَ وَكُلِنْ خَبَتٍ Only some bitter fruit was there. وَأَسْلٍ And tamarisk bushes were there. وَشَيْءٍ مِنْ سِدْرٍ قَلِيلٍ And a few low trees, that's all. ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ Thus we recompense them. بِمَا كَفَرُوا Due to their ungratefulness. وَهَلْ نُجَازِي إِلَّا الْكَفُورِ And this type of reward or punishment we don't give except to those who are ungrateful. وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ الْقُرَى الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا قُرًا ظَاهِرَةً وَقَدَّرْنَا فِيهَا السَّيْرِ Now this nation of Saba, it had the monopoly of the east-west trade before Quraysh. Quraysh actually inherited it after the Saba were destroyed. And what was that east-west trade? All the trading merchandise from east, China, India, East Indies, all these, you know, that used to come and those ships were unladen in the Aden or Yemen, on the coast of Yemen. On the other hand, all the merchandise from Europe that came and shipping was on in the Mediterranean Sea and they were unladen in Syria, Palestine. Now, between these two points, because there was no Suez Canal, so there was no route, sea route was not there between Europe and Asia. So now this was the only link. Caravans went to and forth, to the north, to the south. And they were exchanging this merchandise from south to north, north to south. And this was a much profitable business for them. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made this journey for them very easy. How? وَجَعَلْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ And we had made, set between them, وَبَيْنَ الْقُرَى الَّتِي بَارَكْنَا فِيهَا And between those townships that we had blessed. This is the area of Palestine. سبحان الذي اسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام الى المسجد الاقصى الذي باركنا حوله. The area around Masjid Aqsa, Allah says, we blessed it. So they were, this area was blessed. Now the caravans had to move from Yemen to this area of Palestine. And in between them, Barakna Fiha Quran Zahiratan, we had made so many townships on the way, which were very near the highway, visible from the highway. وَقَدَّرْنَا فِيهَا السَّيْرِ. And then we had set the stages of journey for them. A city, a township is coming after, for example, 30 miles. You can stay here for some time, take rest. If you want to take some food, some water, okay, available. Then continue. So at the intervals, 30, 50 miles, there was a township. So the journey was very easy. There were no long journeys, you know, during which there could be fear of looting and plundering also. But you know, small segments of journey, and because the road was inhabited, there were townships, inhabitations on both the sides, so it was safe also. فَقَالُوا, but they said, رَبَّنَا بَعِدْ بَيْنَا أَسْفَارِنَا. Our Lord, prolong the stages between our journeys. There is no adventure in this journey. There should be some adventure. So there should be adventure, so this journey should be, you know, have some fears. Ba'id bainana wa zalamu anfusahum, and they wronged themselves. Faja'alnahum ahadith, so made them only the bywords. Now only stories are there for sabah. Wa mazzaqnahum kulla muzzaq, and we scattered them and disintegrated them. Total scattering. Actually, what happened after this? This dam, you know, gave way, and there was that big flood and destruction, that these tribes then migrated from there to Arabia. Aus and Khazraj are the both tribes which came from Yemen and settled in Yathrib. The Jews were already present. They were first to come to Yathrib. But then came these Aus and Khazraj from Yemen. Also these tribes went even to Iraq and Sham, Syria. So there also they went and settled. They are the actual Arabs. Al-Arab al-Araba. They are the real Arabs. But you know, Quraysh, they were not Arab al-Araba, they were Arab al-Mustaraba, because they were the progeny of Ismail. Ismail was son of Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he was from Iraq. He was not an Arab. He was Iraqi, Chaldean. It was the Chaldean Empire where Hazrat Ibrahim was born. And the city of his birth was Ur. So these were people who adopted Arabia as their settlement place. But the actual Arabs were these people, who had spread throughout this peninsula from Yemen. فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا فَمَزَّقْنَاهُمْ كُلَّا مُمَزَّقٍ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. Verily, in this are the signs for all of those people who take everything in this world patiently and who are grateful of what Allah's bounties are given to them. وَلَقَدْ صَدَّقَ عَلَيْهِمْ إِبْلِيسُ ظَنَّهُ. And verily, Iblis had proved what he said, what he thought about the progeny of Adam. But Tabu, he said that you will see that the progeny of this person, Adam, whom you have raised above me, they will not be thankful to you. So in case of Saba, the nation of Saba, Allah says at least for them, the saying of Iblis came to be true. لَقَدْ صَدَّقَ عَلَيْهِمْ إِبْلِيسُ ظَنَّهُ فَاتَّبَعُوهُ إِلَّا فَرِيقًا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So they followed him except a few people from among the believers. وَمَا كَانَ لَهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ. And he didn't have any authority over them. إِلَّا لِنَعْلَمَ مَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Except that we wanted to know and differentiate between those who have real faith in the hereafter. مِمَّنْ هُوَ مِنْهَا فِي شَكٍ. From those who have some doubt about it. وَرَبُّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَفِيظٍ. And definitely your Lord is a guardian over everything. قُلِدُ الَّذِينَ زَعَمْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Say, call those whom you think that they are associated with Allah. لَا يَمْلِكُونَ مِسْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. They don't have any control over not even an atom, the weight of an atom, neither in the heavens nor in the earth. وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنْهَا فِيهِمَا مِنْ شِرْكٍ. nor they have any association or partnership with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world or the hereafter. وَمَا لَهُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ ظَهِيرٍ. And now that there is any helper from among them for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةُ عِنْدَهُ. And no intercession would be of avail إِلَّا لِمَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ, except from that whom he has permitted. حَتَّى إِذَا فُزِّعَ عَنْ قُلُوبِهُمْ. You know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave some command to the angels, they were overawed. إِذَا فُزِّعَ عَنْ قُلُوبِهِمْ, when the terror is removed from their hearts, قَالُوا مَاذَا قَالَ رَبُّكُمْ, then they ask each other, what your Lord has said? قَالُوا الْحَقُّ. They reply, whatever he has said is true. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ, and he is the high and the great. قُلْ مَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Ask them, who gives you sustenance from the heavens and the earth? قُلِ اللَّهُ. And say yourself, Allah gives you. وَإِنَّا وَإِيَّاكُمْ لَعَلَىٰ هُدًى أَوْ فِي ذَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. And surely, either we or you are on a right guidance or in manifest error. Either you are right, so we are in wrong. Or if you are wrong, then we are right. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلَيَ دِينَ. Our ways have parted. قُلْ لَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا أَجْرَمْنَا وَلَا نُسْأَلُ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. Say to them, you are not going to be asked about what we did, our guilts, our crimes. You will not be held responsible. Nor will we be asked, nor will we be responsible for what you are doing. قُلْ يَجْمَعُ بَيْنَنَا رَبُّنَا. Say, our Lord will gather us all. ثُمَّ يَفْتَحُ بَيْنَنَا بِالْحَقِّ. Then he will decide between us. He will judge between us with truth. وَهُوَ الْفَتَّاحُ الْعَلِيمُ. And definitely, he is the decider, he is the best judge, and he is the knower. قُلْ أَرُونِ الَّذِينَ لَحْكُمْ بِهِ شُرَكَاءَ. Say to them, show me who are those whom you have associated with Allah as partners. كَلَّا. Certainly not. بَلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. He is only Allah, alone, Al-Aziz, all-powerful, and Al-Hakim, all-wise. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَزِيرًا. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have not sent you but for the whole of humanity, whole of mankind, as the bearer of the glad tidings and as a warner. But لَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people, they don't know. وَيَقُولُنَا مَتَى هَذَا الْوَعْدُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And they are saying, when will this promise come true? If you are true, قُلْ لَكُمْ مِيَادٌ يَوْمٍ مِيَادُ يَوْمٍ. Say them, for you there is an appointment of a day. لَا تَسْتَاخِرُونَ عَنْهُ سَعَةً وَلَا تَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. That day which you cannot put back by an hour, nor can you advance it. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ بِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَلَا بِالَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. And these disbelievers are saying, we are not going to believe in this Quran, nor that which was before it. Now here, Torah also is being referred to as Quran. We have read before, Sehran-e Tazahara. These are two sorceries who have joined hands with each other against us, they were saying, because we believe in Shirk. And Sehran-e, these two sorceries, Torah and Quran, they are against us, Tazahara. Here again they are saying, we are not going to believe in this Quran, nor in that which was before it. وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ مَوْقُفُونَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. And only, O Muhammad, if you could see, when these evildoers will be made to stand before his law, before their Lord, يَرْجِعُ بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَىٰ بَعْضٍ الْقَوْلِ. Now they will be blaming each other, throwing the blame on each other. يَقُولُ الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا. Now those who were oppressed, they will say, لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا, to the arrogant people, لَوْلَا أَنْتُمْ لَكُنَّا مُؤْمِنُونَ. If you were not there, we would have come to believe. You actually led us astray. If you were not there, we would have believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we would have been saved on this day. قَالُ الَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا. They will also give the reply. Then those people who were arrogant, they would say, لِلَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا, to them who were oppressed in the world, اب نحن صددناکم عن الہدیٰ بعد اذ جاءکم دین وی اسٹاپ یو اور پریونٹڈ یو فرام ایکسپٹنگ دی گائیڈنس وچ کیم ٹو یو بل کنتم مجرمین یو ور یور سیلف گلٹی وقال الذین استضعفوا اگین دوز ہو ور اپریسڈ اینڈ ہو ہیڈ ٹو فالو دیئر ایلڈرز اینڈ لیڈرز دے وڈ سے للذین استکبروا فار دوز ہاٹی ونز اینڈ دی اروگنٹ ون بل مکر اللیل والنہار یو ور اسٹرائیونگ ڈے اینڈ نائٹ ٹو پریونٹ اس تامروننا اینڈ یو ور کمانڈنگ اس ان نکفر باللہ دیٹ وی شوڈ ریفیوز ٹو ایکسپٹ دس دعوی آف محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم ڈس بلیو اللہ نجعل لہو اندادا اینڈ وی شوڈ اپوائنٹ ود ہم ایکولز واسر الندامہ آفٹر دس ڈائلگ دے ول ٹرائی ٹو ہائڈ دیئر ریمورس فلنس دے ول بلیم دیم سیلز لما راہ العذاب وین دے ول سی دی چسٹائزمنٹ کم بفور دیئر آئیز وجعلنا الاغلاق فی الاعناق الذین کفروا اینڈ دین وی شیل پوٹ دی فیٹرز ان دی نیکس آف دوز ہو آر ڈس بلیوڈ حل یجزون الا ما کانوا یعملون دے آر ناٹ بینگ ریوارڈیڈ بٹ ایکسپٹ دوز تھنگ دیٹ دے ہیڈ ڈڈ دس از دیئر اون ارننگس وما ارسلنا فی قرية من نذیر الا قال مترفوها and we never sent in any township any warner but the people who were affluent in that town they said inna bima ursiltum bihi kafirun listen with which you have been sent we deny it we disbelieve it wa qalu nahnu aktharu amwalan wa aulada and we have more wealth and we have more sons wa ma nahnu bimu'azzabin and we are not going to be chastised If God had not loved us, why should have given us this wealth in this world? He has given me so many sons, and I have so much land, and I have such and such gardens, etc., etc. What does it mean? They believed in Allah. Only they disbelieved the Akhirah. Allah, definitely He loves me, because He has given me all these things. And definitely I will get these things in the Akhirah also, if there is Akhirah, as you are saying. وقالوا نحن اكثر اموالا واولادا وما نحن بمعذبين we are not going to be chastised قل ان ربي يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء say my lord outspreads this worldly things for whomsoever he likes ويقدر and restricts and straightens for whom he likes ولكن اكثر الناس لا يعلمون but most of the people they don't have the knowledge وما اموالكم ولا اولادكم بالتي تقربكم عندنا زلفى And please know that it is not your wealth or riches or your children that will bring you nearer to Allah. Illa man amana. If you want to come to nearer to Allah, the only way is illa man amana wa amila salihan. Except that who come to believe and do good deeds. Faulaika lahum ajru jazaa'u dhif. For them there will be double, twofold reward bima amilu. Of what they did. وَهُمْ فِي الْغُرَفَاتِ آمِنُونَ And they will be fully secure and in peace in the lofty houses. وَالَّذِينَ يَسْعَوْنَ فِي آيَاتِنَا مُعَاجِزِينَ As for those who are striving against our ayat, our revelations, to defeat them, أُولَٰئِكَ فِي الْعَذَابِ مُحْضَرُونَ They will be thrown in the chastisement. قُلْ لِنَا رَبِّي يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ Say, My Lord, outspreads the sustenance for whom he wills. وَيَقْدِرُ لَهُ And he straightens or restricts for whom he wants. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ And whatever you spend in his way or for his pleasure, he will return it to you. You spend for him, for his pleasure, to the poor, to the needy, or for his deen, he will return it. فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ And he is the best provider. وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا And the day, recall the day when he will gather them together. ثُمَّ يَقُولُ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ Then he will ask the angels, أَهَؤُلَاءِ إِيَّاكُمْ كَانُوا تَعْبُدُونَ Were these people worshipping you? Well, that was the creed of the people of Arabia, that Malaika, angels, are the daughters of Allah. And they are very beloved daughters. And these, you know, Lat, Manat, Uzza, the feminine names, These are actually the images which we have made in the name of those angels. So we worship them. So they will intercede on our behalf on the Day of Judgment. هَاُولَاِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ They will be intercessors for us. So here, وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا When Allah will gather them all, ثُمَّ يَقُولُ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ And then He will ask the angels, هَاُولَاِ إِيَّاكُمْ كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ Were these people worshipping you? قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ They will say, Glory to you. أَنْتَ وَلِيُّنَا You are our Lord. You are our protected Bindu name. We have nothing to do with them. بَلْ كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ الْجِنْ Actually, they used to worship the jinns. أَكْسَرَهُمْ بِهِمْ مُؤْمِنُونَ Most of them believed in the jinns. Now these jinnat came to the kahins, etc., etc. This was a business going on. That was a separate story. So they, Malaika would say that they were not worshipping us. Actually, they were worshipping the jinns. فَلْيَوْمَ لَا يَمْلِكُ بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ نَفْعًا وَلَا ضَرًّا Anyhow, today, none of you can have any authority or for any benefit for one another, or zarar, or any hurt. وَنَقُولُ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا And we shall say to them, those who are evildoers, زُقُوا عَذَابَ النَّارِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ بِهَا تُكَذِّبُونَ Now go and taste the chastisement of fire which you had been belying. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا And when our revelations are recited unto them, بَيِّنَاتٍ which are very clear, shining revelations. قَالُوا مَا هَذَا إِلَّا رَجُلٌ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَصُدَّكُمْ مَا كَانَ يَعْبُدُ آبَاؤُكُمْ They say, he is only a person who wants to stop you, prevent you from those whom your forefathers used to worship. So they actually invoked their respect from their forefathers. And in their name, they wanted that they shouldn't accept the dawah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَسُدَّكُمْ أَمَّا كَانَ يَعْبُدُ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَقَالُوا مَا هَذَا إِلَّا إِفْكٌ مُفْتَرًا And they also said, it is nothing but a forged lie. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِلْحَقِّ لَمَّا جَاهُمْ And said these unbelievers, for the truth which had come to them, إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ This is nothing but a clear and manifest sorcery. وَمَا آتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ كُتُبٍ يَدْرُسُونَهَا And we have not given them any books that they are reading. The Mushrikeen, they had no book, no scriptures. Ahle Kitab, the people of the book, they had the scriptures, Torah, Zabur, and you know the Gospels. But they had nothing. وَمَا آتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ كُتُبٍ يَدْرُسُونَهَا We have not given them any books which they might be reading. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ قَبْلَكَ مِنْ نَزِيرٍ And the second thing is that we did not send before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to them any warner. وَكَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ Those who were before them, they also belied. وَمَا بَلَغُوا مِعْشَارَ مَا آتَيْنَاهُمْ And these Quraysh, these people of Makkah, they have not even attained one-tenth of what we had given them. The wealth and the glory which we gave to Aad, And in the same way, the wealth and glory and power which we gave to Samud, not even one-tenth of that has been given to these Quraysh. فَكَيْفَ كَانُوا فَكَذَّبُوا رُسُلِي But when they belied our messengers, فَكَيْفَ كَانُوا النَّكِيرُ So how was the punishment that was given to them? قُلْ إِنَّمَا عَيْذُكُمْ بِوَاحِدَةً Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I exhort you to one thing only. أَن تَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ مَسْنَا وَسْفُرَادَ That you stand for Allah, either in prayers or singly. ثُمَّ تَتَفَكَّرُوا Then you thought, think, then you meditate, then you try to understand. مَا بِسَاحِبِكُمْ مِنْ جِنَّةِ There's no madness in your companion. Who is companion? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What I'm saying to you, I'm your companion. I am from your tribe. I am also a Qarshi. You are Qarshis. But you think and you will come to know. Just ponder over it. This truth will reveal itself to you that on your with your companion there is no madness nor any evil spirit has possessed me. In huwa illa nazirul lakum. He is only a warner to you. بَيْنَ يَدَيْ عَذَابٍ شَدِيدٍ Before a very strong, severe chastisement comes to you. قُلْ مَا سَأَلْتُكُمْ مِنْ أَجْرٍ Say to them, I have not asked you for any ajr, any reward, any wage, any labor. فَمَا سَأَلْتُكُمْ مِنْ أَجْرٍ فَهُوَ لَكُمْ If I have asked for any wages, then I give it to you. They are for you. Keep them. إِنْ أَجْرِيَ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ My reward, my wages, they are on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will pay me. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ And he is a witness on everything. قُلْ إِنَّ رَبِّي يَقْذِفُ بِالْحَقِّ Say, My Lord strikes with truth. This ayah we have already read in Surah Al-Anbiya. بَلْ نَقْذِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِلِ فَيَدْمَغُهُ فَإِذَا هُوَ زَاهِقٌ Here it is only one part. إِنَّ رَبِّي يَقْذِفُ بِالْحَقِّ This time is not very far off. When Allah will strike you with the truth. What will happen to you at Badr? Is not very far off. Allahul Ghuyub, he knows everything which is hidden and which is unseen. Qul ja'al haqqu, say to them, the truth has come. Wa ma yubdi'ul batilu wa ma yu'id. And as for falseness, it never originates nor repeats. Qul in dalaltu fa innama adhillu ala nafsi. Say to them, if I am committing some mistake, I am erring, then I am erring to my own loss. أَذِلُّ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِي The bad result would come to me. فَإِنِ اِتَدَيْتُ And if I am on the right path, I am guided, rightly guided. فَبِمَا يُوحَىٰ إِلَيَّ رَبِّي So it is due to that wahi, that revelation, that my Lord is sending me. This is humility on the part of the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I am doing something good, it is actually due to the wahi, due to the revelation of Allah which is coming to me. And if I am doing something wrong, well, I am doing wrong to myself. إِنَّهُ سَمِيعٌ قَرِيمٌ Verily, he listens everything and he is very near. وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِسْفُضِعُوا And only if you could see when they will be terrified, when there will be زَلْزَلَةُ السَّاعَةِ The first ayah of Surah Al-Hajj, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّ زَلْزَلَةَ السَّاعَةِ شَيْءٌ عَظِيمٌ When they will see that, and they will be terrified, but then there will be فَلَا فَوْتَ There will be no escape, no place to run to, no place to take refuge. فَلَا فَوْتَ إِذَا فُضِعُوا وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِسْفُضِعُوا Only if you could see, but they will be terrified. فَلَا فَوْتَ But there will be no escape. وَأُخِذُوا مِن مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ And they will be seized from a very near place. The angels will bring them. وَقَالُوا آمَنَّا بِهِ At that time they will say, we come to believe. وَأَنَّا لَهُمُ التَّنَاوُشْ مِن مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ Now, how can they reach faith from a place far away? Time is gone. Time is over. Now if you say you believe, it's of no use, no avail. وَقَدْ كَفَرُوا بِهِ مِنْ قَبْلِ They had already rejected it before. وَيَقْذِفُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ مِنْ مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ And they were conjecturing about the unseen from a place far away. They were saying this and this and this without any knowledge, without any book, without any guidance. وَحِيلَ بَيْنَهُمْ And a barrier will be set between them, وَمَا يَشْتَهُونَ And the things which will they like. All these things that they will like will be for those who are going to paradise. Now they will be barred. A barrier will be set between them and that which they desire. كَمَا فُعِلَ بِأَشْيَعَيْهِمْ As was done with their partisans of aforetime, people like them, they were also prevented from all those things, good things. The nuzul of Allah and the ziyafa of Allah, they are deprived. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا فِي شَكِّ مُرِيبٍ Verily, they are in a very grave doubt. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعَنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ
اللَّهُ The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.